Welcome to Manhwa Recaps, spoilers ahead, watch out, and take care. We see Kalia kneeling behind the apostle tells her that the devil was killed, which surprises her, she says it's impossible. The word death and the devil don't go together, since even if he disappears physically, it cannot be killed. And there is only one exception to a being that can destroy the devil. But there's no way that they'd show up here. Then the apostle says Saw June. He told her before to report everything about him. But she's failed. He tells her it's a serious matter that cannot be ignored, and in typical Manhwa fashion says that person is involved in this matter, without saying who. He then says he knows that she's using the Korean guilds to keep Saw June in line, and that she needs to hurry and make her move. She asks what he means, and he says she needs to put this twisted fate back onto its intended path. It jumps back to Saw June asking Granny Seol what she plans to do from now on. She says that she isn't sure, and she's been living her life secluded from the world, but there's no need in that anymore. And that she'd like to go out into the world again, he suggests that she stay at the Dream Academy for a bit, until she finds out what she wants to do. He explains further how she's surely going to have to plan a lot out, and she'll need somewhere to stay. Of course he just wants someone to testify on the incident to Dark. She says that she can't trouble him like that, but he tells her it's fine so don't worry and it's an honor. She says she'll teach him her spiritual art. He tells her it's alright, then she goes to explain the basics. Then realizes what he just told her, and asks him to repeat what he said. He tells her it's fine, and it's alright to just stay at the guild. She's puzzled on why he rejected her when it's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, but she understands that she's in no place to teach him, and she says it's funny he wants nothing in return. Of course him being the greedbag he is, tells her she can pay him if she wants, she asks if that's really okay with him, he says of course. She says okay, and she'll make sure to include the cost of her life too. He tells her that since she'll be at the guild, some of her old friends will visit so she shouldn't feel alone. She wonders who he means, then it jumps to the Dream Guild. And Saw June is telling the rest how she'll be staying for a while. Everyone is lost as hell, and she thanks him again. He tells her it's no big deal, the rest look afraid of something, and Minyul asks if he's going to do a dungeon raid or not. He says no, since he's tired and they all look relieved. He tells them to get back to training, and they walk off. We see them all doing their own thing, some of them sparring. But Saw June is glued to his phone, Granny Seol watches Minyul sparring, and tells Saw June that's the Dark Saint's technique. He says yeah, then she points out how Suyin is using the Magic Saint's technique, he says yup again. She say leaving Suyin out of it, who the hell are these kids? He then tells her that they are the other Saint's disciples. She asks why everyone is in one place like this and sighs, then she spots Hae-un who is in the corner. And says don't tell me she's also the disciple of another saint. She quickly says she isn't, and sees that she's a little sad about it. Saw June on his phone starts to talk about all of the money he's earned, and now he can take another lecture. And he sees lectures from both Atlas and Thialfi. He says he didn't think he could take one for a while, he didn't expect this. He wonders if he should ask Granny Seol for enough to cover a lecture, saying it should cover the cost of her life. He notices something, and tells Granny Seol to quickly follow him. We see them outside of the guild, and she asks why they are in the alley out back. We hear Dark say he's glad she's alive, then he appears from the shadows. She's surprised, and he says that just confirms there's nothing wrong with his stealth arts. So how the hell can Saw June keep seeing through it? She asks if he didn't intentionally let him see through it. Then she notices the injured and asks if he's okay, then tells him about his disciple and the magic saints. He tells her to take a damn breath, and he'll tell her everything later, so tell him about the dungeon. She starts to explain and he tells her to hold on, and asks if he can explain it. He's totally got something planned. He starts to tell it, saying he went because of the association president, but then he found Granny Seol inside. When he saw her inside he instantly knew that there was something related to Dark, and how he promised him money. So he decided to investigate it with Granny Seol, but no matter how much they searched they didn't find anything. Then he started to smell, the Order of Truth, and he could tell they tampered with the dungeon. He asks Granny Seol to back him up, and she asks if he really noticed all of that. He says of course, then gaslights her by saying remember he told her of the distortion and to summon the divine spirit. She says that's true, then he continues saying then a devil appeared out of nowhere and targeted either Granny Seol, or dear bro. So he quickly bodied it. Dark asks if a devil really appeared, and Saw June says of course, and Granny Seol can testify to it. She says he's speaking the truth, Saw June quickly says he wouldn't lie, but Granny Soul says it's a bit different than she remembers. Saw Jun then starts to bring up the money that Dark owes him for uncovering that they were targeting Granny Soul, but messes up speaking. Dark says alright whatever, and he'll hold his end of the deal. Granny Soul then asks about what they are talking about. Dark says they weren't only targeting her, but every other hero of the Cataclysm. She asks why the hell they do that. Dark says he's unsure, but that the Apostle of Temperance came to find him. Even Saw Jun is surprised that they'd bring out an apostle, and wonders why. His S-tier insight pops and he then asks them if maybe it could have something to do with Berserk. Dark asks what he means. Saw Jun says his assumption might be wrong, so take it with a grain of salt. And how he said it himself last time they talked, how Berserk just disappeared, but it wasn't dead right. And how the disappearance was caused by the Great Voice and the Seven Apostles. Saw Jun asks how strong it was. Dark says it was a monster that's unable to be defeated. And that even if every hero fought together there's still no guarantee to their victory. Saw Jun says that's it, and that since there's no guarantee, nobody knew if the world would end or if Berserk would die first. But what if the Order of Truth knew what the deciding factor was? Dark asks what he means. He says it's future prediction, they can see the future. It may not be perfect, but even if they can see a bit of it then they'll know something. And perhaps their observation is a part of it. Dark says keep going, and Saw Jun says the Order of Truth saw a future in which Berserk would be defeated, even though the heroes would suffer serious losses, and that's how they made their decision to know Berserk shouldn't come out now. In other words, the Great Voice and the Seven Apostles intentionally made Berserk disappear. Granny Soul asks why they do that, and what does killing the heroes have to do with that? He says it's because only the heroes can fight him, that's why instead of releasing Berserk they want to take the time to eliminate those who can fight it. And when nobody is left to fight it, they'd release Berserk into the world again. They say that'd be the end of the world. Granny Soul says even if what he says is true, they just need to stall for time. He says well yeah, since they are all boomers. It's just his assumption, but the Order of Truth might be unable to contain Berserk forever, so they are running out of time. Think about how many distortions are occurring, it must be connected to Berserk somehow, maybe his power is being released. He says he has two ideas. One is that as Berserk's seal is weakened his powers leak out and cause distortions, or the second which is that the Order figured out how to utilize Berserk's power. But it could be possible that both are right, but he's not sure since they are just ideas he wanted to share, based on the assumption that the Order wants to end the world. But that's not what they've been doing. If they had such impure intentions they just had to watch instead of helping the people with the heroes. He scratches his head, saying there's a lot of things that don't add up, but that's all he has for ideas. Dark thinks that it all sounds ridiculous, but if what he said is true and Berserk is free, he doesn't know if they'll be able to stop it. But he thinks that it's possible if it's Saw Jun. Saw Jun then asks what his plan is now. Dark says he plans to figure out what kind of organization the Order of Truth is first. And that he plans to go abroad, since as long as the Apostle is aware of him he won't be able to be active in Korea. He'll figure out what the Order is planning to do, and he needs to figure out if their targets are only the Korean heroes, or all of them. He then asks Granny Soul what she'll do, and she says that she doesn't know. She's lived so disconnected from the world and she wants to go back to connecting to the world with Saw Jun's help. Dark says that's alright, and he's not sure why she turned away from the world, but it's a good idea to let the world know that she's okay. He says that might be why she wasn't threatened by the Order. Then he tells Saw Jun to be careful, since they've been keeping an eye on him, they might not be keeping a watchful eye. But they know about him, and due to the recent devil incident they'll understand he's a problem. He says that's all he wanted to say, and he's not sure when it'll be. But he'll be back when he has more info. He goes to leave, but Saw Jun stops him and scares him. He reminds him to pay him before leaving the country, and Dark wonders if he found him solely from the smell of the money. It jumps to the association president and everyone in a riot saying they won't want to give an S-rank license to someone who has no achievements. Other hunters are trying their best to become S-ranks, so why would Saw Jun be given it randomly? They all start spitting and barking and they go to ask if it's a joke. The association president says that's his line, asking if they think he's doing this because he's bored. And so what if it's considered special treatment? He says if he were to give the Sword Saint an S-rank license would they try to stop him? They ask what nonsense, but he cuts them off saying to just answer. They say that a higher rank license would be more fitting for the Sword Saint. The association president says that the Sword Saint hasn't raided a dungeon since the Cataclysm, so why? He has no achievements that they are demanding Saw Jun have, but with the Sword Saint they all know his sacrifice and skills, but the same can be said about Saw Jun. Hero-ranked hunters must be treated accordingly, even if it's special treatment. They start to talk about how he wasted tax dollars, and he says he had two. Then asks if they know what'd have happened if the Draugr dungeon had broken open. The damage amount would have been astronomical, and there'd be a crazy amount of casualties, would they have handled that? The guy starts to get absolutely slammed, and can't even reply. The association president says on the topic of fairness, he doesn't understand what they mean. They start to talk about how it's too early for Saw Jun to become an S rank. The association president thinks about how they aren't unaware of his skills, they are just being unreasonable. And that it's all got to be because of Ryu's political control. He then says they are the ones wasting the taxpayers' money, and they should feel ashamed as government employees. And that from his moment on Saw Jun will become an S rank. They try to stop him, but he leaves the room. And we hear a familiar voice saying it's their first time meeting, and she calls him Tae-bum. We see it's Kalia. It of course doesn't show us their conversation yet, and we're back to Saw Jun and a man named Park Eamon is introducing himself as a member of the Dungeon Management Department, and a part of the Hunter Association. Saw Jun says it's nice to meet him, but what's he doing here? Eamon says he has something important to talk about. Saw Jun says that Tae-bum could have come in person, or is this unrelated? Eamon says he can't come right now, and Saw Jun begins to release his aura saying don't tell me that he's trying to get out of giving him the money, right? Eamon says that's not it, and the money's already been approved, so he'll get it in a few days. Saw Jun calms down, and says sorry he got too excited. Eamon says while people don't want him to be an S rank, Tae-bum is pushing for it, so it'll be fine. However, since it's unprecedented, he's come to convey the situation in Tae-bum's stead. Saw Jun asks about the money again, and Eamon repeats what he said before. Saw Jun laughs saying okay. Eamon is surprised he didn't even care about the S rank license, and only wants the money. And how everyone else would have picked the license over the money, since being an S rank hunter means you stand at the top of the hunter world, and you cannot earn it with money. But he wonders why he doesn't care. Saw Jun then asks if he'll have to pay taxes on the money. Eamon says that he's a money goblin, and tells him no, and that Tae-bum will visit him soon. Saw Jun says okay and hums while leaving. Eamon has a flashback of him talking with Tae-bum, and how he doesn't understand why Saw Jun is being given an S rank. Tae-bum tells him that the current pro hunters are all sickening, and it's corruptly run by the Big Five guilds, and they are ruining Korea. He's tried to make it right, but all they could do was maintain status quo. And all this time he's been forcing himself to believe nobody can stand up to them all. But for some reason he thinks that Saw Jun will make it happen. As he's planted a seed of hope into his mind, and that's the true purpose of an S rank. Eamon smiles saying he understands now, then calls out to Saw Jun, and bows saying he's not sure if he has the right to say it, but on behalf of their country he really wants to express his gratitude. Saw Jun starts to cringe and tells him to stop. Then to jumps to the next day as news of Saw Jun began to spread around Korea, it started with how he cleared the Draugr dungeon then went to his guild and how he's obtained an S rank license. There's even articles about him being Korea's sixth hero. And a lot of people from the Dark Dragon Guild began to spread hate, we see Saw Jun shocked on his phone. But it's not because of the news, because he hasn't even checked it. It's just about his money, he starts to talk about how much the lectures are, and how he's finished his elixirs. And how he's missing half of the money to do what he wants to do, he smiles out of pure joy. Then mental booms asking what's the point of being an S rank hunter and increasing guild rank. If all of the money he made will be gone, he wonders if casualty is something shitty or if it's just him, and he sees in the chat board that everyone is flaming it. And that nobody is having a good time with it, and some of them were scammed. He realizes he's not alone with this, then we hear Tae-bum, he enters and says he's sorry for coming in early. Then asks where Granny Soul is, he tells him she's upstairs resting. He asks if he's here for her, rather than him. He says no and he came to tell him something, and it's nothing much but Kalia visited him the other day, asking for him to help her. Saw Jun is surprised, and Tae-bum says he's hesitant to ask, but does he know anything of the situation is Europe? It jumps to a city in Europe, it hasn't said where specifically and. We see giant monsters running rampant, and there are hunters trying to fight them back to hold them off, and there's a little girl crying too. Saw Jun asks what the hell is going on. Tae-bum says it's the situation in Italy. Saw Jun asks how this happened, since there shouldn't be a shortage of hunters. Tae-bum says that distortions are happening all over Europe. and the Italian government tried to calm the situation down by mobilizing professional hunters, but it wasn't enough. Then Granny Sol appears saying Andrea was meant to be there, and asks if it's too difficult for Andrea to handle it. Tabum asks if she's talking about Sir Andrea from the Cataclysm days. She says yes. He then tells her he died recently. It was a dungeon accident, and a distortion occurred while he was inside. It's not just Italy, but all over Europe there have been reports of distortions, and the heroes are fighting it, but they then ask the Order of Truth for help. Saw Jun asks why he's telling him all of this, and he says that Kalia asked for Korea to help Italy. Saw Jun asks if the Order cannot handle the situation in Italy. Tabum says that's not the bigger issue, and Granny Sol says it's Andrea's death. He wasn't only a hero, but he was a godfather in the Mafia. The Sicilian Mafia was the first to unify the Mafia. Andrea was crazy and kept yapping about rehabilitation of the Mafia. She thought it was all just nonsense. She lets out a sigh and looks sad. She says Andrea has opposition in the Mafia, but nobody could handle Andrea. But now that he's gone, it's obvious they'll be going crazy. Tabum says that's right, and the Order has their own issues to handle. Granny Sol asks why he's getting Saw Jun to do something even Andrea couldn't, asking if it makes sense. Tabum says he refused, but Kalia asked for the message to be delivered at least. But there's no issue for Saw Jun to act, and he shouldn't go to Italy since it's dangerous. Saw Jun thinks about it, then says something, but we don't get to hear it. Then it cuts to the Apostle asking if all he wants is money, and he asks if Saw Jun doesn't know of their goal. Kalia says she doesn't think so. He asks why he wants money then. Kalia says he's just a money goblin. The Apostle is speechless. Then asks for how much he wants. She tells him he wants 75 million, and the Apostle says yeah, he's a psycho. Kalia says that he offered to go with his guild, rather than solo. The Apostle says alright, give it to him. And since the monster that killed Andrea is there, why would they stop him from going? And there's not much time left until she becomes the Apostle of Chastity, and once she does she'll understand. She seems really nervous, and he asks if she has more to report. She says he wants the money in advance, and the man is stunlocked. Back to Saw Jun asking if they'd want to go, they instantly say they can't wait to go as it's a vacation. He tries to tell them it's dangerous, but they are too smooth-brained. They continue to ignore him, and ask when it's time to leave. Granny Sol is confused by how they are acting. It cuts to her trying to drink some tea, but it's too shaky so she keeps spilling. She says it's shaking more today. We learn the team's trip has been confirmed. Saw Jun took 60% of the funds he was given, and gave everyone else 10%. Granny Sol wonders how much money he even needs. There are 2 weeks left until they leave. Everyone starts to tell her good morning, and we learn Saw Jun is the reason it's shaking, as he is doing squats with a lot of weight. She wonders what the hell he's holding for it to shake like this. Then she starts to look at how all of the other saints have their disciples here, and Saw Jun is the one who grouped them all together. Except for Heyun, who seems a bit out of place. She then uses spiritual energy to look at her soul and says that they take different colors based on their inclinations. And her soul, means her personality is poor. She asks Heyun why she's here. She says she just happened to come here, and Granny Sol says she isn't telling the truth. Heyun starts to blush. Granny Sol says originally it'd have been normal if her soul was completely black, it'd be similar to Ryu's. But her soul degeneration has stopped. Maybe it was due to Saw Jun opening her worldview. She says that Heyun is a child who doubts herself and tries to change, but remains isolated because she doesn't know how. She jokes, saying even the gods cannot control human affairs. Then tells Heyun to follow her, to work on her personality first. Heyun is hesitant, and Granny Sol asks if she doesn't want to. Heyun looks nervous, and Granny Sol sighs. Then flicks her forehead, saying she needs to stop being dishonest. Heyun asks why, then gets interrupted by a flick to the head. She tells her there are 2 weeks left until they leave for Italy, for now it's time to root out her rotten character. Then she turns all drill sergeant, telling her she'll only take yes for an answer now, asking if she understands. Heyun goes to say pardon, but says yes. Saw Jun sees all of this, and says that's pretty odd. We see his skills have leveled up from watching lectures, and 2 weeks later on the news people have been informed of the dream team going to Italy. They finally arrive in Italy, and it seems like Mignol has shaved his mustache. He and Suyin start to run off for pizza and pasta, but Saw Jun barks at them. Then we hear a man say hey, and he turns around to see a group of men. So Yun asks him what they should do, and he tells her that someone from the government will come pick them up soon. Plot convenience ensues, and we hear a woman asking for the dream team. She introduces herself as Elena, a member of the Italian Hunter Association. Saw June says it's good to meet her. She thinks to herself that she thought an S-rank hunter would be coming, but says she's looking forward to them helping. Some men walk up and start speaking to them in Italian. Saw June asks what they are saying. And Elena says to just ignore them. He then notices a little orb in front of him, and he asks what it is. It's Hayun's, and she's trying to make a spiritual connection. He can now hear what they are actually saying, and Saw June shakes his head saying they just want to fight. Then one of them say to leave them be and they'll die anyway, but it's a shame the beauties will die, so maybe they should have some fun before they do. Saw June glares at the men. Saw June tells Elena to excuse him for a moment. She then says since the mafia members aren't the usual gangsters, and they are A-rank hunters. She tries to stop him, saying he's not their opponent but. So Yun puts her arm out, and tells her that it'll be alright. Elena looks around and wonders why nobody else is worried. The mafia members start to laugh at Saw June, and he says considering all the trash sitting around here Italy must be in shambles. Then he grabs one of their faces and slams him into the floor, before the other had even a chance to react. The rest of the group begin to jump towards him. And Elena is confused saying this isn't possible. She wonders if he's really just an A rank. Saw June tells her they can go now. We see them heading down the street, and she tells them they'll be heading to Naples. Elena then says that the people he just fought weren't the mafia. Well, they were, but they are a separate group. And after Andrea died, the mafia split into three groups. Agnese of the Moderates, Francesco of Manliness, and Antonio the official successor to Andrea. Asides from Antonio's group, the other two are just criminals. Even throughout the chaos of the dungeon breaks, the hunters are having to delay dungeon responses due to the rampaging mafia. So they hope the dream team can handle the dungeon distortions. He tells her to leave it to them. Elena bows her head, thanking them. Then the car comes an abrupt stop, only Hayun smacks her head. Saw June wonders what's happening. Elena steps out of the car to see citizens running away. Then is shocked as she sees a dungeon break right in front of them. Before she can panic, Saw June pulls out Gungnir and launches it at the monsters, instantly killing them. She is stunlocked, and the rest of the dream team get out of the car too. Saw June says looks like Naples can wait, and they'll start right here. It jumps to the Italian parliament, and they are discussing how a mafia faction has taken over the city of Catanzaro. They tried to negotiate, but they won't say anything other than to accept their conditions. We're introduced to the Italian Association President Marcello. And we learn that the Manliness faction is the one occupying the city. He's threatening to kill the citizens if he isn't given the position of president in a week. The Prime Minister Samuele facepalms saying he's ridiculous. He asks about Antonio, and we learn he's working with the pro-hunters to stop some people from leaving Sicily, but it's not going well. Samuel sighs saying this never happened with Andrea alive. He didn't think the absence of a hero would be this bad. A man runs into the room yelling that the dungeons in Latina have become distorted. Samuel asks Marcello how many hunters they can dispatch. He tells him, then he asks about those from other countries. Samuel gets angry asking if their citizens need to be sacrificed again. While shaking he says to mobilize the pro-hunters, and to save the citizens without risking their own lives. A man then tells Marcello something, and Samuel asks what's going on. Marcello says that Latina has no casualties, and of course we all know that's because of the dream team fighting the goofy-looking monsters. Suyin uses a flame technique to wipe out her side. Minyul uses his dual blades and darks techniques. We see Soyun approaching hers, then she quickly unsheathes her sword killing her side. Surprisingly Hayun is using a spiritual art from Granny's soul to wipe hers out. While Elena is escorting all of the civilians to safety, the civilians ask who's helping them. Elena looks over to see a lot of stumpies from Maple Story, running amok. Then a giant streak goes across the sky, and she sees Saw June as the reason. And tells them that they are Korean hunters who came to help them. She says that a site that would have needed to have dozens of hunters, was cleared by only five. Then she gets a call on her phone, we see it's from Marcello, and she answers and firmly introduces herself. She's surprised by what he said, and that the Prime Minister is doing something. We see Suyin asking Hayun how she's using spiritual arts like that, saying it's not been long since she started. Hayun then compliments Suyin since she just awakened not too long ago. Then Suyin asks Minyul how he's so strong, he says he's always been training. Soyun sighs wondering why everyone around her is so talented. They say she's the one who wiped out most of the area, she says compared to how long she's trained compared to them she's lacking. Elena and them are confused, and we watch as Saw June starts to dismantle the monsters. He notices Elena, and says he was going to ask what he had to do to sell the corpses, then asks about the people behind him. He's then introduced to both Samuel and Marcelo. He wonders why they are here. Then he asks a question so random they turn into stick figures. Samuel sticks his hands out, and introduces himself formally. Marcelo introduces himself too. Saw June tells them who he is, and they are surprised he doesn't need an interpreter to speak to them. He says it's because one of his members can use spiritual arts, he doesn't know how it works but it's some translator thing. Hyun says if Granny Soul heard this she'd faint. Saw June asks what they are doing here. Samuel then asks if he can please help Italy. Saw June is lost since that was his plan initially, so why the hell did they come here to ask him about it? Then they bring up the magical word, money. Samuel thinks that Saw June isn't interested at all in the money, but says that's all they can give. So Samuel tells him they'll not charge any fees for the monsters he processes, and they'll cover the costs related to butchering them. Saw June starts to see the pearly gates due to how much blood is flowing to his head, and he starts to have a stroke saying he'll help. Samuel then asks if they can handle the situation in Lazio, which is an administrative region in Italy, with Rome being its capital. Saw June starts to think about it, and Samuel says he knows it's an unreasonable request. Saw June looks up then sees a helicopter. He asks if they can use it, and his eyes start to shine with greed. It jumps a bit, and we learn they've been going city to city clearing the distortions out. Samuel watches his from headquarters as it's a speedrun. He says this shit is wild, and he wonders when the last time this has happened. Then he recalls saying back when Andrea came back saying he'd rehabilitate the mafia. This is the same feeling he got from that. He thought Italy was doomed because of his absence, but they cannot miss this chance the Dream Team has created. He tells Marcelo to leave the citizens to the Dream Team, and get all the pro hunters. And they'll use this chance to draw out the mafia bastards. All over the news there are articles about Saw June, and we see Francesco reading it. He tells Albano his henchmen that it's time to meet Agnese. Albano asks what to do about the hostages in Catanzaro. Francesco says what else needs to be done other than just killing them. It cuts to a banquet of food, and we see the Dream Team staring at all of it. Elena tells them they've rented the entire hotel for them. Saw June then asks how much they've been paid so far, and she tells him how much, which makes him blush. He starts to get in his feels, and she asks him if he's okay, but Mignol tells her to just leave him alone, he's a creep when it comes to money. Saw June snaps out of it, then quickly buys Atlas and Thialfi's lectures. He's hella excited. He says his money may have evaporated, but considering the money he'll earn in the future and what he's been promised so far it's fine. He then asks her what Italy's total annual budget is. She tells him and he smiles with pure greed. He starts to laugh like a freak, and Elena is lost. The rest talk about how he's in a good mood. We get some Atlas lore, how he's the Titan known for holding up the sky in Greek and Roman mythology. He's even stronger than Heracles in regards to pure strength. We see him asking what they think the most important thing is when holding up the earth, and it's not strength or anything like that, it's just perseverance. While strength is needed, it's nothing without the perseverance to back it up. He says imagine you're holding it up and you get hit in the stomach, or a snake bites your leg. Imagine the weather is extremely harsh, he says excuses will not stop you from holding it up. Saw June says those are more than just excuses, I'm with him on that one. Atlas claps back saying they're just excuses, and you have to be able to hold the sky up in any situation. You should never let go of the sky. There are three basics of perseverance he'll teach in this lecture. Unbreakable body, so you can withstand any blow, immunity to poison, and immunity to harsh weather changes. He laughs saying this is the ultimate power behind perseverance. His daily tasks then get assigned, and we see they are actually absurd. Like carrying 500 tons, withstanding 1000 degrees, and take Jormungandr's poison. He says ignoring everything else, what's with the task of the poison? Wondering how he's meant to acquire it, then we see that it's extremely expensive, and he says spending that much daily is ridiculous. He inhales copium, saying he'll get some of Italy's annual budget, but nobody ever mentioned anything of it before. Then he decides to check out Thialfi's lecture. The hotel shakes, and we hear something crashing down, and he wonders if another distortion occurred. Some mafia members appear, asking where Saw June is. Elena tells them to go away and it's not a place for them to enter. They laugh at her, saying she needs to get lost before she gets hurt. But she instantly takes one out with a whip or something. She says that she warned them. The rest charge at her with their weapons. but she swings her whip and starts taking them out one by one. One of them calls the rest idiots, saying to stop rushing in, and to group. But she wraps it around his leg, and uses him as a weapon, swinging him around to hit the others. She then lets him go, and keeps her pressure up. She says it's going well, and she can get reinforcements at this rate. But she gets grabbed and thrown into the floor. She coughs up blood, and we see Albano saying he didn't expect Elena to be here. She asks how he got here when it should have been blocked off. He says it's none of her business, and to answer a question for him. Then asks where Saw June is. She asks if he really thought she'd tell him. Then we hear the Dream Team, who are pigging out, asking what's going on here. He sees Mignol, asking if he's Saw June. Mignol says no, and if he's looking for the captain, then he's right behind him. Saw June quickly grabs Elena, and Albano wonders when the hell he got there. Mignol keeps pigging out, saying looks like he's gotten faster. If you've watched till the end, comment, Allosaurus, to let me know. Subscribe for more videos like this, leave a like or a comment to help the channel out. Thanks for watching.